then when the guard comes, he's gonna chase us out. I have to do this shit again, right? Hey, it's good to see you. You must be wondering like why I'm out in the open, not in the studio, and wearing my helmet and all. I have a surprise for you. So I've got this message from one of our subscribers, Derek Mohan, and he's saying that, Andrew, I noticed that you are probably a motorcyclist. I wonder how you know. He probably saw one of the episodes where there was a... Was there an episode where there's a motorcycle? But anyhow, Derek is telling me that he customizes and builds motorcycles, and he's going to send one of his motorcycles that he built to be featured in Bike Active. So if you're a biker, this is the website that you want to feature your builds. So Derek is having his motorcycle featured here, so he want to send them photos, and he's saying like, Andrew, so since I'm a subscriber to your channel and also your premium courses, I wonder how I can shoot this effectively, both natural lighting and also maybe use one flash. So Derek, here's the good news. You have come to the right place, you have talked to the right person, and you're subscribed to the right course. I've gotten you a motorcycle that I built too with my friends. It's a bobber. It's a little bit dirty because it's been raining here a lot every day. So we're gonna shoot this today. I'm gonna show you how you can do this effectively with no flash, natural lighting, and then we're gonna use only one flash. And hopefully that we can get the photos nice enough for Bike Active. Because I actually did some research. Bike Active wants the photo to be clear, sharp, and if you want to shoot them dark and all that, don't send it to us. So Derek, you've come to the right place. Let's get started. Wait, I think we need to send the bike for a wash. Yeah? Oh my God, it's like too dirty. You know what? I'm just gonna spend 2 hours doing this and you guys are gonna give up on me, right? You idiot! When are you gonna shoot the bike? I'm gonna turn on the grid line so that we can see how level this is. Right, so by pressing info, I call out the grid lines, which is this. Okay, for a first shot, this turned out not too bad. Not too bad, but not good because this thing here above the headlamp is kind of annoying, and also this plastic conduit here and also this fire hydrant alarm here needs to be removed digitally. And second thing, I feel that we need to add a bit of contrast and saturation to this photo. I may need Tashan, our editor's help. And this is how it looks like after touching up. Okay, looks like to shoot the whole bike, I will continue with natural lighting. So I did a few of these shoots and I did the same thing. I increased the contrast, the saturation, and clean up a little bit of the background and the floor. And these are the photos. Okay, great, we're gonna move on to tighter shots and some close-up of the motorcycle. So if you look at what those photos submitted to Bike Active, you can tell that when it comes to shooting the whole bike, most of the time it's kind of like natural lighting with minimal flash or maybe no flash. But when they come to close-ups, they're gonna use a bit of flash. You can tell from the specular highlight here. So we're gonna try to replicate this as much as we can by using only one flash with a flag. So I need my producer Yi Chong's help.
I just realized I brought a Canon flash fitting on a Nikon camera, so I cannot use TTL, it's gonna fry the flash. So I'm changing this to manual mode, which is fine, it's gonna drive by one pin. So mode, alright, let's try. Okay. You hold the flag like so. Nearer if you can. Okay, so we increase the power to half power. Come in nearer to me. No, nearer to the bike, but then nearer to me too.
What?
this.
Yeah. Put it more to the top. Okay, come nearer to me a little bit.
Oh, it's hitting on a buy. Look, it's overexposed.
As little bit of finger if you can. Yeah. It can't be at the top. I can see your finger. Right. That would be good. Okay, closer to the bike. And yeah. So I'm gonna hold the flash so that it can light up better. See, this is the mistake. You can see a specular highlight. Okay, so I'm gonna push this up a little bit at the edge, point it there. Good. Push it higher. Okay, go.
Whoa, check that out.
This is without a flash. This is with a flash. Come somewhere, this side. Okay, that's perfect. Stay there.
Oh, this is nice.
This one back up a bit. That one come go there a bit. Ah, okay. Okay, stay.
Oh, my hands.
Yeah, I have no light stand. I have no tripod. Yeah. Yeah, then you're going to have no more arms after this.
Alright, great. Those are the glossy parts of the bike. Now we're going to shoot the really reflective, shiny part of the bike, like the mufflers and all the chrome parts.
So I'm going to push this to full power. The brighter the light, the darker the shadow. So I have to correspond by adding the F value, which is now F13. Point this flash here. Oh, this is good. This is too bright now, so I can bring up my shutter speed. And then F16, let's see what we get now.
So you notice that I use a higher power flash is because that will create a brighter light, and with brighter light that will drown the ambient light, thus creating darker shadows, creating a shot that is more solid with contrast.
Let's do a natural lighting. This is at F4 and an ISO of 800, shutter speed of 100, and
F7.1. Derek, that's how we shoot a motorcycle out in the open with flash and without flash. Only one flash, or even if you don't want to use flash, you still look exquisite. So I hope you visit my e-learning website here, like what Derek is subscribed to. We have the e-learnings, more than 20 over courses that we have here, specific genre. And then we have our premium courses, even better. For monthly or yearly subscription, you get all this content with fresh new videos and lessons uploaded every week. And then we also have premium courses and e-learnings combined, and you call this the All Access. That means you can access all the content we have in the website and show some love. Let's be better in photography. If you are looking for somewhere to be better in photography, look no further. It's my website and it's truly affordable. Thank you. See you soon. You are, you know, somebody shooting a BMW convertible there. And they're like, vroom, 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 oi. Be content friendly. Don't rev. Better cut.